Oh my god.
Hi. Wait, who's here?
This is Luke from DNA.
Is this Sachin from DNA?
Is one more to describe your dress style?
Colorful. I love color. I think out of 365 days, you'll see me in black 5 days.
What's the strangest gift you ever?
I think I've received like something weird from a fan, like maybe from their surgery. That'd be the strangest gift. My mom always gives me very strange gifts. I love her so much, but you know how moms can be.
You smell to create one sentence.
I hope this new album that comes out August 28th helps put a smile on your face.
What's your hidden talent?
You can look like a frog.
Oh. Oh, wow.
Disgusting.
What's a movie you will watch several times?
Maybe Fifth Element or Blade Runner or, oh, like the other day, like Mars Attacks by Tim Burton.
What's your favorite phrase?
Oh, I say, okay, so I say a lot of times, I will say, and that's the whole bit, sitch. Like, that's the whole situation. Or I do also like to say, better late than ugly. So yes, I was a little late, but that's probably because I was trying to make myself look more presentable for you. Yeah, well, this is the album cover, yes. The album is about finding your happiness again after losing it. I don't know how you would say it in Mandarin, but I feel like a lot of people suffer sometimes from depression and or anxiety, and you know, they hold it deep inside and it doesn't help. For me, I had to go and I had to explore my mind and my heart and go on a journey in order to really understand why I was so sad. Because I was really sad for a few years in 2017 and 2018 and a little bit in 2019, but not in 2020. I'm feeling a lot better. And so this record is about finding the light at the end of the tunnel. Yes, I am so desperate to come and do a big tour in China, obviously when, you know, I'm allowed, but that's probably top three, like one of my biggest goals for my career. And I've been able to do so much, right? I've been able to play the Super Bowl. I've been able to have so much success. I've been blah, blah, blah. But like, I haven't yet been able to do a big tour in China, kind of like what I do in Brazil. And, you know, I've done in other big countries, but that would be really important for me. So hopefully I will start to get back on the road next summer if the world is, you know, cool with that. But I'll be ready. By the way, a lot of my Chinese fans, I see them. They come to my shows, they hold up a sign, they say Fruit Sister something. And they're like, I'm from Beijing, I'm from Guangzhou. And there'll be like 5 or 10 of them in 10,000 people every single show. But they'll be like the first ones in the very front. They're so like passionate and they will travel so far. I would love to see more. Well, I've been able to be very creative. I've made like a performance video for Smile. And then I have so many other music videos, big and small, that are coming when the record comes out. So I have 12 songs on the record and there's probably like 10 videos or what have you, but it's not like Lemonade by Beyonce, because nothing is. But there's a lot of fun things to dive into and to have visual, like a fun visual story that represents the song. You know, obviously we're utilizing technology just like everyone else, but I like to have a little bit more fun with it. I always dress up in different hair and costumes and, you know, I'm always adding just a little more. Yeah, I mean, I'm I hope they understand how much I appreciate and love them. And that's why, you know, I think it was either in January or February, I was like, I love you. I hope you're okay. While the whole world was kind of, you know, watching and not sure or what have you. And my Chinese fans are beautiful, passionate music lovers. Again, I want to come and see them and I want to put on a great show. And they're always there for me. I see lots of, on my Weibo, it's like wild, you know? Now there's this dark horse challenge. Make me a fiddle, you know that one? So I guess that's something fun and new. But there, I just saw like some examples of it and they're amazing. Like these girls are singing much better than me. I'm like, whoa.
Make me your Aphrodite and make me your one and only.
Daisies was difficult to make. It was difficult because I was at the end of writing the whole record and I just was so tired. I didn't have anything left. I was like, I can't do another song. I don't have anything left to say. And it was kind of like, it's kind of like milking a stone is what they say in America. You know, when you like try and get water from a rock, not very possible. That's how I was feeling as far as songs, but I got it. I pushed myself, which is good. But also there's one song on the record called Only Love that I had to finish singing in quarantine. So in my bedroom, not in like a studio or anything, just in my bedroom with my sister's husband, who's a producer, in my pajamas. I have a little video I'll probably share with people once it comes out, and just like, it's pretty funny what you know, all the different things, that the twists and turns that you have to be doing during this year. I mean, there's so many, but I would like to make an acoustic record in the future and do something really mellow. I want to do a song with Dua Lipa because I just love her. We have fun together. I just want to do something fun. But so many people, I'm always open to collaborations. Actually, it's the song is as important as the person, because if it's not the right song, it doesn't feel like it'll work. You either have to write it or, you know, figure it out. Hello to the followers of Achin and Luke. It's Katy Perry here. My new album, Smile, will be out on the 28th of August. Make sure you check it out. I love you guys. Thanks for watching.